We could be better if we do this together. Better you, better me, better us.
Hi, gorgeous. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name's Lydia. And if you're not new here, welcome back. So I've been getting a lot of messages on an update. I've been getting a lot of questions on what's the update with my HSG test. And I am so sorry, I totally forgot to do an update and let you all know how the test went and what were my results. So I'm here at my mother-in-law's house and my husband came to watch the Super Bowl, so I brought my girls to the backyard because they were bored. So I said, why not just do the little update right now? So my gynecologist said that everything looked normal and that I have no type of scarring and there's no blockage, so there's nothing to prevent me from getting pregnant. So the next step would be for my husband to get checked. And you already know how guys are. I'm still trying to convince him there, but it looks like he's almost convinced because it's something that we both want, not just myself. So I think he's going to cooperate. Of course, I know that it's all up to God when it's going to happen. In no way am I trying to rush things. I just want to find an answer, whether it's even a possibility, whether it's something that we can even think about pursuing. And like I said in my other video, in no way am I unhappy where my life is right now. I am super happy and I feel super blessed to have three beautiful girls, but my husband and I do want more kids. So we're just wondering what is going on because it's about to be 3 years that we've been TTC and we haven't had any success. Just a lot of us thinking that I am pregnant and then I end up testing and it turns out to be false. And of course, there's a lot of sad moments, and not just us, the girls as well, they've been actually asking and asking and asking and talking about that future baby brother or sister. And of course, this is something that I do not talk to them about. Like, I'm not like telling them, oh yeah, mommy and daddy are trying to conceive. Of course not, you know, because it's not a conversation that you will have with kids their age. But it's something that they're always talking about, and all I can do is tell them that it's not up to us, it's up to God whenever he wants to give us another baby. But yes, it's a conversation that roams around the house a lot. So it's really hard for me not to even think about it. So yeah, I don't know what it consists of, why it hasn't happened yet. I've had one C-section, which was my first, and two vaginal births. So I honestly don't know what's going on. I got everything you can get checked. I got it checked, and according to the gynecologist, everything looks okay. Everything looks normal. So she can't find a reason why it's not happening. But she did tell me we can undergo fertility treatments, and this is something that my husband is not okay with because we are Christian. So as a fellow Christian, I would like to ask you, what are your thoughts in this subject? Do you think God is against it, against undergoing fertility treatments, or does he approve of it? Because we don't want to go against what God wants for us to do. And of course, I've been trying to find all kinds of natural ways of helping my fertility issues. Like I told you ladies on my previous video, I did start taking spirulina about 2 months ago, so we'll see if that helps in any way with my fertility. And I will keep you ladies updated with that. So it's just something that my husband is concerned about. He thinks that I'm going to try to force things or go against what God wants for us to do. I mean, I've definitely been praying on it, but I would like to hear your opinions and your suggestions on that subject. That was my little update. Thank you all for watching, and thank you for all your support. Enjoy the rest of your day watching the Super Bowl or spending time with your family and chilling. I love you all, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye!
Was there something I could have said to make you?